Here's a quick little video to certain globies who don't seem to understand Polaris angles. This is what they usually come up with. Most of them, they have all these little parallel lines, and they say, you know, they got the angle, and they claim it hits Polaris, this little dot. Now, in their model, this little dot is gigantic. You can say, oh, they all point to Polaris because that's 44 million miles in diameter. And this is only, what, 12-something in diameter, which means each one of those would intersect with Polaris. Now, here's the problem. It's not going to move. It's going to stay here because, according to globies, the sky isn't moving. So here's the Earth. We're going to go around the sun, you know, 6 months later. We're over here. Here's our tilt. So now it's like this is when the south is tilted towards the sun. Over here was when the north is tilted toward the sun. What we're going to have is when it comes over here, that's 186 million miles from here to here. So remember, 44 million mile diameter, that's not even going to come close to over here. So even if I put all their little lines to Polaris aimed at a 44 million mile diameter Polaris, oops, it's not over here. It's over there. So that's an impossibility. The model for Polaris angles doesn't work on a globe orbiting the sun.
In this video, I'll be working my way through a GeoGebra script that will demonstrate what is really happening with Polaris. And you won't be too surprised to discover it's nothing like what that silly flat earther Gary Wybenga just said. And this is what I'll be attempting to simulate. Just like in Gary's drawing, the Earth's axis will be tilted 23.5 degrees. But in order to make the script much easier to write, I'll be rotating this whole picture so that the Earth's rotational axis is aligned with the Z-axis. So stick around while I show how the globe model does indeed make it possible for an observer in the Northern Hemisphere to acquire their latitude based from their angle to Polaris at any time or place in the Earth's orbit. We'll start with putting a point for the Sun at the origin. And above that, on the Z-axis, Polaris, whose distance is controlled by slider W. Gary made a big thing of Polaris having a diameter of 44 million miles, and its size is irrelevant. All that matters is for an observer on Earth to be able to see it. With the ecliptic plane in place, and to keep things simple, I'll just use a circle to represent the Earth's orbit. The radius values I'm using for the orbital path and for the Earth won't be to scale because, simply put, there'd be too much zooming in and out trying to get a sense of what's happening. But there's nothing stopping anyone from entering the correct values. The results will be the same. Next to add are the North Pole, the South Pole, the equator, and the meridian line that can rotate by way of this point, Q. Now we're ready to add our observer using the intersection point of the meridian line we've just added, with a circle of latitude which is governed by the lat slider above. Before we add the lines that will allow us to measure an angle to Polaris, let's just check to see if what we've done so far works. So this is our latitude slider. That works fine. We can rotate the observer, and we can also move the Earth around the orbit. So this animate box should work. So the Earth is spinning and it's going around the orbital path. So now I want to add a direct line of sight from our observer to Polaris, together with the two vectors we need to measure the angle. The first vector is along the line of sight, and the other is along the observer's zenith. And with these in place, we're now ready to measure the zenith angle. So let me draw your attention to this text over here. This is the latitude we selected, and this is the expected zenith angle to a faraway Polaris. This is the distance from the sun to the purple point that is tied to the z-axis. This is the measured angle between the two vectors. And this last line should be the observer's altitude to Polaris, which should also match the latitude. But before I set this thing in motion, let me just quickly add a yellow GP point for the sun. Okay, let's start the animation and see what happens to these text values when we start to move Polaris away. Let me just alter these speeds. It's a bit better. So let's start to move Polaris away. Looks like it's stabilized. You can see the GP here. So it should cross the equator around here. And then if we go to the x-axis where it crosses there, that should be 23.5 degrees north on Cancer. The equinox again. And then Capricorn should be over here. Let's take us down to the equator. And all the way up to the North Pole. What was it you said again, Gary?
The model for Polaris angles doesn't work on a globe orbiting the sun.
Well, that's it for this one. Let me know in the comments what you think Gary's excuse will be. Hit the like. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll catch you later.